I teach sixth grade math. I'm looking forward to a great year with you.
Hi everyone, I'm Mrs. Graves. I teach sixth grade ELA in room 6, and I'm looking forward to a great school year.
Hi everyone, it's Mrs. Menjivar. I teach sixth grade math in room 5, and I can't wait to meet you guys. We're gonna have a great year. And remember, even though we're 6 feet apart, we're in it together.
Hi guys, I'm Mrs. Bull and I teach sixth grade reading, and I can't wait to meet you.
Hi sixth grade, I am Mrs. Smith. I teach sixth grade math in room 1, and I look forward to seeing you this year.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Mrs. Brundage. I teach sixth grade ELA. I'm in room 3. I'm super excited for all of us to be back together again. I can't wait to meet you all.
Hey everyone, it's Ms. Moz. I teach sixth grade math in room 21 in the middle school hallway, and I can't wait to meet all of you.
Hi sixth grade. My name is Mrs. Tiffany Burek, and this year I will be teaching social studies, which I am super excited about. We're going to start off learning about the pioneers, the Native Americans, the Wild West. We'll get into the Civil War, industrialization of America. I am really looking forward to getting back into the classroom and meeting all of you. I'll see you next week.
Hello, my name is Miss Little. I am your sixth grade learning support teacher. I will be teaching ELA and math. I'll be pushing into some of your classrooms, and I can't wait to meet you guys in a few weeks. Have a good day.
Greetings, sixth graders. Welcome to Corinne Middle School. How exciting. My name is Mrs. Andrzak. I'm the autistic support teacher, and I can't wait to meet all of you.
Hi, I am Miss W. I teach life skills, and I am so excited for this school year to start and to get to meet you guys.
Hi, I'm Mrs. White. I'm going to be your sixth grade science teacher this year. I'm originally from Cory, Pennsylvania, so I probably know many of your family members, maybe even had your mom or dad in class. Just want to tell you a little bit about myself. I am married. I have 3 adult children, 2 of which are married themselves. And I have 3 dogs, Toby, Tucker, and Teddy, and he's probably my favorite. And look at him laugh. We love to go camping together, bike riding, traveling. Another little interesting fact, we've been to 43 of the 50 continental United States. I guess I'm just really excited to get back into the classroom this year and hope that you are too. I know we might have some challenges, but I think things are going to go pretty well. So I guess we'll see you in another week. All right. Bye.
Hello everyone, I'm Mr. McGinnity. I am the middle school counselor. I look forward to meeting and getting to know each and every one of you over the next 3 years in middle school. I hope you have a great rest of your summer, and if there's ever anything you need, I'm here for you. Stand up with your face to the sky.
Hi, sixth graders. My name is Andy Passenger, and I'm the assistant principal for Cory Middle Senior High School. I know this isn't how we expected to experience your sixth grade orientation, but we also didn't expect all this crazy stuff to be happening during the pandemic. But we're going to make the best of it. So I want to welcome you to a new school year. I would like to take you through a couple of talking points on a short presentation before you enter the building. Once you enter the building next Tuesday, you're going to have a chance to follow your schedule, meet with some of your teachers, check out the rooms, and you'll also be able to practice on your lockers, which I know causes an awful lot of anxiety.
Feeling good, like I should.
So when you get here on Tuesday night, you'll park in the parking lot.
And then you'll make your way toward the West Gym doors, where you'll be greeted by some sixth grade teachers. We'll then take you to the sixth grade wing, where you can follow your schedule, check out the classrooms, and practice on your lockers.
So we're gonna move through a quick presentation on your sixth grade orientation. So we know it's a time of transition, certainly from the fifth grade to the sixth grade, which creates a lot of emotions. There's going to be some anxiety, and what we're going to try and do, and what I want you to understand, is that our teachers understand that, and they're going to help you for weeks and weeks until you feel comfortable with this school. So even though you haven't been in here as much as we'd like, you're going to have teachers that are going to be looking out for you, protecting you, and making sure you get to the right places at the right times. One thing we want to take a look at is understanding your schedule. So you're going to get a schedule that looks just like this. And what you want to focus on are the blocks here, 1, 2, and 3 in the morning. Notice those are year-long classes. It's going to show you what room you're going to, who your teacher is, obviously the course title, and you don't have to worry about these. These are for us. You're also going to see your sixth grade level, your homeroom teacher. You're going to have a guidance counselor that's going to help you out. So if we go back down here, we know our first, second, and third block are going to be year-long classes. We're not going to worry about the fourth block right now. So we know in first block all year, I'm going to have social studies and science with Mrs. White. Second block, if I trace back, I have math 6, whole group with Mrs. Smith. Third block, I'm going to move to a small group of math with Mrs. Smith. If I look at the afternoon, notice that you're going to have your English courses and reading courses and your writing course. Teachers, that's going to be during 5th, 6th, and 7th and year long. Again, do not worry about fourth block. That's going to be your encore class, and we're going to help you and work with you for a couple of weeks to make sure you know where you're going to go. But for just tonight, I want you to look at the first three blocks, follow that schedule, and then the last three. Just to explain what your encore is, and again, we're going to help you with it. Each day is going to be a different encore. So you might have band, chorus, music, phys ed for a semester, different courses, family consumer science, your tech ed classes. Again, I've already mentioned this, teachers will help students. They're going to walk you to your encore classes, and we're going to help you get there and know where those are. So if you haven't logged into Sapphire before, that's a platform we use in order to keep track of grades. So if it's your first time, you can go to our website, and you'll see the step-by-step instructions to do that, where you'll activate an account. And for parents, this is really important. You get to keep up with your child's grades. You'll see them daily, possibly weekly, depending on the course and how long it takes to grade from some teachers. But you can get frequent updates in that regard and keep track of those grades throughout the 9 weeks and throughout the year. It's also a great form of communication. It allows you to see those grades and maybe contact teachers so we're not waiting to the end of the 9 weeks. And teachers will contact you as well. New this year is our Community Eligibility Program, CEP. Our entire district qualifies for all of our on-campus students for free lunches and free breakfast. If you're interested in downloading the School Cafe app, you can certainly check that. Any money you put on there would be simply for a la carte items. Let's move to the student drop-off and pick-up. So you will see, and we have the high school here. You're going to come up Avenue A and come down South Street, or come down South Street here, and you're going to enter the back end of the parking lot. You can see that you're going to stay to the far right. Follow our lanes up through here, and you'll stop near the front once directed. Your child will get out here, and they will cross to the sidewalk, and they will walk up the sidewalk and enter near the west gym doors. So this is the east gym, or the new gym that we call it, and you have the west gym in here. The doors will be right in here, and that's where they will enter, and their exits will be here at the nurse's room door and out front to the buses at the end of the day. You're not going to exit this way. You'll be directed to exit this way. We have students and people coming in from the parking lot here that are driving themselves. So we're not going to have traffic crossing here. So again, coming up South Street, you'll come up here, stay to the far right in our lanes, drop off. When you are directed to, please leave this exit and out this way. Just a couple of housekeeping items. Chromebooks are going to go home with each student to be charged at night and be used at night, depending on homework. And that way, if we do go into a fully remote experience, students will have their Chromebooks. Excuses we need within 3 days. We have a no cell phone policy at the school. If students bring them, they have to stay in lockers turned off. They're not to be used during the day at all. Students will have agendas, and those will be for organizational purposes. They may be used as passes, but specifically for keeping track of homework, teachers may have them use them as organizational tools. We'll ask that you return your emergency cards. Those are important for us to get phone numbers for not only parents, but any emergency contacts. We do have a middle school point system that we started last year for keeping track of behaviors. And for those with negative behaviors, there are points that add up eventually where you start to lose privileges. And eventually, you may lose privileges for the end of the year trip. Obviously, we are trying to build a very positive school environment, and we want you to be as positive and be a part of this group as much as possible. We finally move into the locker combination aspects, and you will get a combination card for that night when you come in, and we're going to have a short video that shows you what to do and what it looks like. In just a moment, we're going to show you the video of how to open your locker. Before we begin, you're going to clear your locker by turning it to the right. When you're ready, you're going to start on whatever your first number is. So we're clearing it to start over. We're going to start on our first number, which is 23 here. Go all the way around past 23 until we get to our second number, which is 43. And notice then we just turn back to our third number. We don't go all the way around again, which is 21. Lift up and your locker should open. Please watch this as much as you want. I know it creates some anxiety when it comes to lockers. Your teachers are going to help you. Your administrators are going to help you. You will not be yelled at for being late if you can't get your locker open. Okay, we're trying to relieve some of that concern you have. You will have plenty of time and get used to opening the locker.
I know it wasn't a perfect orientation, but thanks for joining us. We can't wait to see you on Tuesday. And if you're a fan of Star Wars like I am, I can't wait to talk to you about it.